But it was no big, romance. I mean, the stories came out, the girl he left behind, and all that. It wasn't like that. I mean,
Elvis Aaron Presley was born January 8, 1935, in Chappell, Mississippi. Presley grew up dirt poor in Chappell. He moved to Memphis as a teenager and with his family was off welfare only a few weeks when producer Sam Phillips at Sun Records, a local blues label, responded to his audition tape with a phone call. Presley produced 5 singles from 1954 to 1955 with the Sun label, where it was then his management was turned over to Colonel Tom Parker. He was a country music hustler who had made stars of Eddie Arnold and Hank Snow. This would be what would catapult Elvis in the music industry. From 1956 to 1958, he completely dominated the bestseller charts and ushered in the age of rock and roll, opening doors for both white and black rock artists. Presley became the teen idol of his decade, greeted everywhere by screaming hordes of young women, and when it was announced in early 1958 that he had been drafted and would enter the U.S. Army, there was that rarest of all pop culture events, a moment of true grief. In 1960, Presley returned from the Army, where he had served as a soldier in Germany rather than joining the Special Services Entertainment Division. Upon his return to the States, he picked up pretty much where he had left off, churning out a series of more than 30 movies from Blue Hawaii, 1961, to Change of Habit, 1969, over the next 8 years, almost none of which fit any genre other than Elvis movie, which meant a light comedic romance with musical interludes. Presley was now a mainstream American entertainer, an icon, but not so much an idol. He had married Priscilla in 1967, and without much fur, became a parent with the birth of his daughter, Lisa Marie, in 1968. On July 31, 1969, Elvis kicked off a 7-year-long residency at the International Hotel, which was later known as the Las Vegas Hilton. During this time, however, Presley had also developed a lethal lifestyle. He lived nocturnally, surrounded by sycophants and stuffed with greasy foods and a variety of prescription drugs. His shows deteriorated, and in the final 2 years of his life and his recording career came to a virtual standstill.
They asked me to do it, and I was anxious to do some live appearances. You know, it's been a long time since I've been on stage in front of anybody live. And I was anxious to do some live appearances, and I thought it'd be a good opportunity to get in front of the people.
Have you ever seen the inside of the dome before?
Never have. It scares them. It's a big place.
The man who had risked everything, including potential ridicule, to make himself a success, now lived in the lockstep regimen of an addict and recluse. Finally, in the summer of 1977, the night before he was to begin yet another concert tour, Elvis died of a heart attack brought on largely by drug abuse. He was 42 years old.
Goes by so slowly, and time can do so much for you. Still
Cause I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me? When you don't believe a word I say.
Welcome back, my pretties. I hope you enjoyed the beginning of the video with Elvis and the interview, and I just really got excited to do the video with about Elvis and seeing what his last meal was, which I was shocked to see what his last meal was. Ice cream and chocolate chip cookies. I do have that on hand, but I figured that's kind of easy. And since this is cooking for the dead, I kind of wanted to cook something for Elvis. And one of his staple things that he loved to eat was the banana, peanut butter, and bacon sandwiches. Now, I'm on the fence about about this sandwich. Because, first of all, peanut butter and bacon with banana. This is questionable. This is a questionable sandwich, but we're going to try it for Elvis. Okay? so pray for me right now. The peanut butter is, oh my God. Let me see if I can show this without holding the plane. Let me just, like, look at it. Just look at it. You see that? It's like gooey. Ooh, it's falling out. Okay. And just so you know, FYI, I like my bacon crispy. So if you were like questioning my bacon, well, that's why. I don't like my bacon to be like leather. No. I like it crispy. And I'm going to give you a tip. Okay? If you like coffee and you like black coffee, dip your bacon in that black coffee. You will thank me later. I promise you. And if you don't want to dip it, you know, if you're kind of like, you know, ooh, take a bite of some bacon and then sip some black coffee and tell me that is not heaven, because that is heaven in your mouth. So, all right. Enough about me. Okay, more about Elvis. So let's give this a try. And if you have tried this sandwich, let me know in the comments. Say, I've tried that sandwich and I find it very fascinating in my mouth. Because I'm not excited for this. Okay. Prepare. I'm prepared. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Well, I don't know how I feel yet. Okay. So, that's actually not bad. I think I get it. That is actually not bad. Now, would I eat that all the time? No. But it's not bad. I get why he done that now. Or why he liked it. Because the bacon has the salty aspect to it. And then the banana has the sweet aspect to it. And I have found that
sweet things and salty things can actually have a good combination to them when properly. So that is not bad. The peanut butter kind of gives it, I don't know, like, you got the sweet, got the salty, but you got the creaminess, the nuttiness, like, don't go there. But the peanut butter, it all ties together very nicely. I will say that. I don't have a problem with that. That's actually really good. So yay. That passed for me. I understand why Elvis loved that. But I would not eat that all the time because that's a lot of calories. But that would be a good treat. That would be a really good treat. And speaking of treats, let's enjoy his actual last meal. Okay. I don't think I got any peanut butter and stuff on me. Okay. So his actual last meal was 4 scoops of ice cream, which I will not be doing today. I get this. This is what I get because I'm a lactose intolerant girl. So I have to get the non-dairy Netflix and chill. This is the best. One of the best. Ben and Jerry's is good anyway. So we got that for the ice cream. And then, you know, now I like chewy and the regular, but we got chewy this time. So that's what we're going with. I'm going to have a cookie for Elvis and I'm going to have a spoonful of ice cream for Elvis. So here's the cookie. It's chewy. We love her. Okay. That's always a good one. So, the paranormal aspect or part to Elvis. While I enjoy this ice cream. Before my dinner, by the way. So, there is quite a few stories about Elvis. In the paranormal way. Now, I'm going to share with you some of those. Okay, I'm going to read to you some of these. So if you want to grab yourself a snack and listen to me tell you. Now this is from the Houston Press, which you can find online. Okay. So this says, you're unlikely to have anyone bother with your ghost after you die. The most us regular folks can hope for, usually, is that we may stick around our old house for a while, making cold spots. I would be doing more because, anyways, I'm just that way. Maybe if you're unlucky enough to die in a noteworthy or particularly violent way, you might end up haunting your murder site or something. Okay, it didn't have to go there. It didn't. I know it had to, but it didn't. Okay. Nobody's trying to be murdered. Or die violently. Thank you. But if you do, I'm sorry. Okay. I'm going to keep going. As with everything else, though celebrities exist in a realm above our own, Marilyn Monroe, for instance, is reported to haunt at least half a dozen places now. I just done a Cooking for Dead with Marilyn Monroe. So if you want to go back and watch that, go right ahead. Her meal was fabulous. I just didn't have champagne to go with it, but it was great. Elvis gets around as a specter just as well as he did touring the country while alive. So where can you spot the ghost of the king of rock and roll? Well, let's find out. Of course, the most obvious place to start is Graceland in Memphis, where Presley lived until he died at the age of 42. That is so young. And on this note, Austin Butler, If you have not seen the newest Elvis movie, Austin Butler played Elvis. He went to Graceland. He found some connection with Elvis. Like, it was strong connections. You can go and look at his interviews. They're on YouTube. Austin really got close with Elvis while visiting Graceland. So if you want to check out some of those interviews, you can. He had to speak like Elvis so much, now it's like it's hard for him to get out of it. That's how it's so interesting. But anyways, it says you can find plenty of reports from rather interesting individuals who have claimed to sense a supernatural presence in the mansion. Strangely enough, they do all tend to pick the same place as having a buzz or a vibe. The Graceland kitchen, for example, shows up time to time, again in blog posts about paranormal researchers making the Graceland pilgrimage. There are also tons of YouTube videos showing what the posters say is the face of Elvis peering through the curtains at the windows. Actress, sorry if I pronounce this wrong, Paz de la Hierta, even says the ghost of Presley made her this is getting personal. Like, really personal. I'm not, like, that's a genuine reaction. My spoon just moved. Yeah, it just moved. I don't know. That was weird. Why? Awkward silence. I'm sorry. I'm trying to process that one. Because I'm standing right here and it just moved. Like, for no reason. Anyways. Let's go on. So, this actress claims that Presley made her orgasm through ectoplasmic touching when she visited Graceland's recording studio. He is on the roll, even on the other side. Another venue that claims the ghost of the king still wanders its halls is the Las Vegas Hilton. Near the Strip, the hotel's nightclub was packed by Presley whenever he performed there, and it was the site of his final performance as a singer in 1976. Elvis's ghost has been sighted in multiple locations in the hotel, in the penthouse suite where he once stayed, in the basement where he would hang out with his musicians before and after the show, and in a freight elevator where he often hid away from the mob of fans.
And the camera died. So sorry, but anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this Cooking for the Dead featuring the king of rock and roll, Elvis Presley. And I hope you guys have a good week, day, night, wherever you are when you see this. And until next time, stay sweet, stay smart, and stay safe. Bye.